Hi, in this tutorial we will see how we can bind sub-object elements to an external object. Here I have this object and these two boxes here, and I will select the vertex sub-object level. You can choose any sub-object level. I will choose vertex, and I will choose these vertices. Now I want to bind these vertices to this box. Basically, I want to bind the transforms of these vertices to this box. That means when I move, rotate, or scale the box, these transforms should be passed to these sub-object elements. So keep these elements selected, and from the modifier list pick the linked XForm modifier, click this button and choose this box. Now I will choose the box. You can see if I move the box, the vertices will move with it. If I scale, and if I rotate, if I go here and turn off the linked X form, the base object will return to its initial state. So now let's say I want to bind the same object, but I want to bind different elements to a different object. Here I can add an edit poly modifier or an edit mesh modifier. Also I can use the mesh select. Mesh select is lighter than the edit mesh or edit poly because it has fewer controls, and we can use it to select sub-object level elements. I will this time I will choose polygons. I will choose these polygons here, for example, and I will add another linked X form. And I will choose this object. Now I will choose this box. I can animate the control object. These two boxes are called the control objects. So I can press the auto key. I can move the time slider. You can choose this one. if I press play, and if I turn off the two links, I can restore this object to its initial state. I will add a turbo smooth to this object. I can hide these two objects here and press play now. I have a small artifact here, some overlapping, it's okay. Here, another scenario where I can use this modifier. I have this wall with two frames. I can go to vertex and select these vertices here. Add a linked X form and choose this frame. Now, if I choose the frame, I can move it around, and the hole in the wall will go with it. Also, if I scale, you have to be careful in some places here, you might have some artifacts. If I want to also bind this wall to this second frame, I can go here, add, like I said, you can use this or an edit mesh or edit poly, but I will choose the mesh select. Choose these vertices, add a linked X form, and choose this one. Now I can move the frames. Third scenario, a third scenario here, I have this table and this object on top of it. I can choose, for example, these vertices here. Now I can, if I move this object, if I don't like the result, I can just unlink. If you see some weird behavior, try to, if you don't see the movement is happening the way you want it, just try to uncheck this option here and see if it it helps. You can also use it for the object level, not just the sub-object level, if you like. For example, here I can have this box and this teapot here. I can add the link X form to the box. I can choose the teapot. I can also bind an object to another object, and if you don't like the result, you can just uncheck, turn off the modifier, and that's it for this tutorial. I hope you like it, and if you do, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel, and see you next time. Thank you.